doing something different today because we have a free kitchen. There's no one in my house at the moment. I don't think people might be coming back soon. But we're going to quickly try and get the majority of this done now before anyone comes home. I am making my sugar cookies. So I am. I'll probably get you to preheat the oven as well. Graham's currently over there. He's putting baking paper on the trays while I make up the dough. So you'll see a couple of time lapses of me mixing the dough and all together, but it's mostly going to be one or two time lapses of the dough being mixed together. So, because it's all kind of in one. So first off, I need to separate the egg. Because the white part of it is only going to be for the icing later. So it is. I think I'll just do it between my fingers because I don't trust the egg cup. Okay. Yeah. Right. So this has been put to one side for later when we do the icing. So it is. I'll leave that there. And now I just basically have to put in everything. So, well, the butter's not too hard. That's grand. Turn on my little weighing scales and measure out 140 grams of icing sugar. I made these the other day for the kids in work. So what I did was I basically made the dough here at home one night, brought it in, let them roll it out and cut out some shapes, which I actually need to get because some of my shapes were upstairs. But I have different ones for today. I have Disney ones for today as well as other shapes. Okay, then we need some vanilla and then we just put the block of butter in. Mixy mixy, and then we start adding the flour. Pretty sure, yep. I have the recipe up on Graham's phone in case you're wondering where I'm reading the recipe from. Okay, so this is when I'm going to go into a time lapse because this gets noisy. So I'm going to go time lapse, mix this all together, and I'll be right back. Okay. So there's the consistency. It's a bit like a buttercream kind of consistency. So it is. Whatever happened with my weighing scales there. But now is when we start putting the flour in. So we're going to be putting this in a little bit by little. And I don't think my bowl is big enough. So there's 150 anyway, because I need 375. So I do. So I'm going to sift this in and then weigh out another bit. They all ready to go?
Uh-huh.
Grand. So that's 150 put in so far. Up the tree is 75. And there we go, mixing again. Okay, so it's starting to turn into more of a cake kind of texture. But we need it a little bit drier than that for cookies. So 150, so that's 225 I need. Oh, bang on. Nice one. So now I'm going to put the rest of this in, mix it up, and I will show you the consistency then. Yeah, you can take them.
Do you need the bottle though?
No. Don't think so, no. So I'm just going to sift this in, then I'll mix it. And then I will start rolling, well, not rolling it out, but because it has to sit in the fridge for a few minutes just to harden a little bit before I start properly rolling it out. So this is going to be the last mix and then I will show you. Okay, so that's it all mixed together. I am covered in flour already. And you can see now it looks a bit more like kind of breadcrumbs, kind of scrambled egg going on. If you hear the water, don't mind. Graham is currently going to be washing the, I need the mixers washed for when I do icing later. Okay, so I'm gonna get a bit of flour now. Dust the countertop and then pour it out and start kneading it together. Is what I'm gonna do now. Try to get as much of the dough out of the bowl as I can. This is gonna be the fun part. I love kneading the dough together.
You need it.
It's all sticky and messy. And this is a really good recipe though. This one is from the Cordially Invited book that Zoe Sugg released a couple of years back. I've started doing the recipes from it and I started doing cookies out of it and everyone just fell in love with them. Like even in work, they're always asking me to bring them in and do them. So, and I promised the kids they could make them in there one day, but have to make the dough at home. So I would, because it has to sit overnight. Well, not overnight, but it has to sit in the fridge for a little while to set and kind of come together a bit more. So it does, okay. My big mound of dough. Look how good that looks. Right, so this is gonna go into the fridge. I'll probably just pop it in the bowl for 2 seconds. So that's gonna go into the fridge. I'm gonna clean up the counter and my hands. I'm sorry, is I joking? On my own saliva. I'm gonna clean up the counter and my hands and then in about, how long does it say to leave it in for? Ooh, wrong way. 30 minutes, so in about 20 minutes to half an hour, I'll be back and I'll be rolling the dough out, cutting out the shapes and baking them and making the icing, melting the chocolate, decorating them and all, whole shebang. So we'll be back in about 20 minutes to half an hour to show you the actual making of the biscuits, like the cutting out and all. And we're back at a different part of the kitchen. We were down there last time. Now we're up here because this is near the cooker. Right, it's been a couple of hours, mostly because my mum, dad, brother and nephew arrived back. Or Steve arrived downstairs, he was upstairs, but the others arrived back. Then Susan called over. So, haven't got to get into the baking yet, but I'm going to get into it now. The oven is on, and I'm going to roll out the dough. I also have a big selection of cookie cutters. This is like an old box that we had of cookie cutters. This is new. I only bought that the other day in pennies. So I want to pick out a selection of cookie cutters. Because I got loads. These are semi-new. Sorry about that. My dad came in. Okay. So I have a big selection of cookie cutters. I'm not going to be using these because these are too big. So they won't be used, but I have a whole wide range of like circles, squares, I have like a little heart, little people, candy cane apparently. Then I have my new Disney ones, so I'm definitely using these. And then I found these, which I might put on after. It's edible glitter, so I have like a silver and a pink, so I might put some of that on after. Graham's after doing this iced toast with this indented in it, so we'll see how that goes. But for now, we roll out the dough. Keep thinking I hear something from me.
I want to know.
Cookie time. Right, I'll just take a lump of it. I'm not going to do it all in one big go. I need flour. Just a tiny bit. Just to stop it from sticking to the counter. So I do. And a little bit on the roll. Now, I'm not going to do all of them on camera because you get quite a bit out of this. But I will show you a couple of them. So I will. Just to show you, and then I'll show them on the tray as well. So, roll this out. Don't know how thick I want them today. Probably not too thick. I'm going to start off with Disney because why not? So let's start off with, try and make them all similar size so they all cook at the same time. So I'm going to start off with this. What are you doing? We're in a video. gonna go with Mickey Mouse.
Mickey Mouse.
A couple of Mickey Mouses. And a couple of hands. Let's do. See how easy it is to get the hands out as well. Oh no, not there. Just fix that. See how easy these are. Grab me a tray. Oh. You are actually annoying me.
Okay.
Seriously, go away.
Didn't work.
Fascinating. Right, I'm going to use a knife. Try lift these up because they're kind of falling apart. So there is a Mickey Mouse. And then get this one. Oh, that one's cleaner. There's an even better Mickey Mouse. Freeus. Why was that put back down? Try the glove. Oh, I ripped the finger off a glove. Look at that. I'm just going to quickly show you because I'm not going to do all this on camera. I'll do the decorating bit on camera, but there's some of them. The gloves aren't working out great. Mickey Mouse isn't too bad. But I'm going to go off. There's my selection. And I'll do a quick clip each time I fill the tray, basically. Okay. First tray done. Some of the hands, the gloves ones, aren't great. But we'll see. I'm going to pick maybe the smaller hand next and the bigger Mickey Mouse head or something. I'm not too sure. But I'm going to switch it up. I am going to do like a good few Disney ones because I want to make sure I get a good few Disney ones.
Disney.
But I have loads of cookie cutters here that I want to try out. But these are going to go into the oven now. And then I'll take them out and I'll show you. But I'm going to show you the other two trays anyway as I do them. Second tray. Tray number two. All little tiny bears. They're all misshapen. But anyway, this one lost his leg. But they all look pretty cool. So this one's going in now. Next. And then on to tray number three. Third tray didn't go as well, but there is a few good hearts on it. So I'm going to wait for the first tray to finish cooking, and then I'll start cutting it more. But for now, this is the third tray, and it's going in. Okie dokie, okie dokie, lemon chokey, look at all the biscuits. The little bears are all stacked on top of each other, and so are some of these because I ran out of space on my cooling tray. But some of them are broken, like this Mickey Mouse lost an ear. There's a glove here somewhere missing a finger. But anyway, they still look pretty cool. I ended up just doing a load of circle ones at the end. So I did, just because it was taking so long to do the other ones. I decided just to throw in a load of little circle ones, which I don't really mind. But I got little love hearts, circles, Mickey Mouses, some Mickey Mouse gloves, some little bears, and I love it. I'm thinking of doing these for like people for their birthdays as well. I think that'd be pretty cool. I just had to find the right cookie cutters for each person, basically. Because like Disney would be kind of me, mostly. Because that's like my main favourite thing.
They get you.
Yeah, so I have to see like Graham, I would have to get like Marvel or DC, like superhero ones. Maybe, yeah.
I'd have
specific ones. Like if I get like an Xbox one for Graham or like a PlayStation one for Simon, you know. And then if I could get like maybe friends or something for Susan, that kind of thing.
You know. Think they can get a couch. And she can pivot it into her mouth.
We'll see. See what I can do. I might be able to make like a picture frame or something. That'd be pretty cool. But yeah. So basically, I'm going to let these cool down for a while because the circle ones mostly are still very, very hot because they're just out of the oven. But we're going to let them cool and then I'll be back to decorate them very, very soon. Hello. Back down this end of the room now for making of the icing. So we are. So I have my egg white from earlier that we need. And icing sugar. That might have been a nice one to give out. Might end up. And you can see Graham's little head. Hello.
Hello.
Right. Gonna make the icing first. Now, I can't remember, do I need to add water into this as well? Not 100% sure, but sure. We'll see. I don't need loads of it, I only need a little bit, so it shouldn't take too long to whisk up. And then I will go and make, then I will go and make, melt even, I'll melt the chocolate. And then we'll get decorating because the cookies are nearly done. So I'll be right back. Look. Icing is done. So now, we need the chocolate. I'm going to get Graham to melt the chocolate. Can you melt the chocolate?
I'm too bad at chocolate.
Right, I'm going to go melt the chocolate. 1 minute. Okay. Melted chocolate. So now, I'm going to sit the phone somewhere and decorate a few of them on camera. Then I might do a little time lapse of decorating them and then show you the finished product at the end. So, I'm going to go and sit up the phone somewhere. Right, very odd angle, but anyway. Right, here's a plate. We have a plate to put the cookies on that we've decorated. I'll try to keep my arm out of the way. Right, I'm going to do a Mickey Mouse head. Graham is my assistant beside me. I don't know if
you
can. Hang on, let me try. Actually, turn it this way. Ooh.
Okay, just keep it on you.
No, it's on top of a placemat. No, if you shimmy a little bit to the side, you basically. Hello.
Hi.
So, Graham is going to be doing a few as well. Yeah. He's dipping. Oh, they're so crumbly.
Oh my god.
We're going to try dip the gloves in white chocolate. Or in the white icing and make them look like the Mickey Mouse gloves, but they're very crumbly.
They're very tender, so they are.
That one was already broken, don't worry. So. Mickey Mouse! That Mickey Mouse looks so good! Yeah, if the hand wasn't broken, that would have looked a lot better. Let it drift for a minute. Shimmy it a little. These Mickey Mouses are turning out so good. I'm going to try and use the spoon when the icing hardens and put like the little black marks on the gloves to make it look more like a Mickey Mouse glove. Right, let's go for this fella next. Okay. Let me show you some of the chocolate. Oh, the Mickey Mouse ones I think are going to turn out the best.
Yeah.
Look how cute they look. Oh! I dropped that one. Probably should have had a cheat towel beside me, but I have a glove. I have an oven mitt. That'll do. Right. I think I can fit one more Mickey Mouse on this plate. Dip. Shake off some of the excess. Shimmy it. Okay, the Mickey Mouse are definitely turning out the best.
Yeah.
Oh, the Disney one's like. We'll see what way the other ones go. Right, I'm going to try do a couple of little bears in chocolate as well, because I think that'd be cute. There's a little bear. I know I shouldn't be licking my fingers, but it's only my family that's going to be eating these, really, so. Ah, that's so cute! Show the camera. Look, it's a Mickey Mouse glove! Ah! I need to practice actually making the Mickey Mouse glove cookies. Because design wise, I think we have it. Oh no, his little foot didn't get you.
Any more gloves?
Yeah, there's two more here. Look, I did little tiny bears in chocolate. That's my first plate. Done. So, I'm going to hop on over and do a time lapse now of us decorating the rest of them. And then I will show you the finished product after. Okie dokie. Last ones.
Grandma got you covered.
But she's got arthritis. Right, we have one left. I'm just going to do the last one. But basically done. This is the first plate we did. This one's mine. Where is it? This one. Look how perfect that looks. But I'm currently eating this one because it kept breaking. So this one was Mickey Mouse. It is now dead. I'm never eating it. Yes. Look how cute. So I have like a two-toned Mickey Mouse there where his ears are kind of like white. I mean, the chocolate mixed in with it, but anywho. I have a heart. It's upside down, but I have a heart that's meant to be two-toned. There's a chocolate one with a drizzle of icing. There's some hearts. There's the gloves. They look so cool. I don't know what that design's meant to be, but one of them's Granny. I don't know what the other design is, but it's something. I can't tell. What is it meant to be?
I don't know.
Did you just drizzle icing?
Mm-hmm.
Right. Then there's Graham's other ones. Look how cute. There's a yin and yang. They're cool. So there's all the biscuits. Yay! They look so cool. I'm really happy with the Mickey Mouse. So I am. But I did realise the Mickey Mouse biscuits have to be quite thick or else they're going to break. Same with the gloves. So they're going to have to be slightly thicker cookies. But they still taste mighty fine.
Now the chocolate bear.
In a minute. I have to get full. So I do. The chocolate started to harden. For true, so you can see like some of them are like a silk, have like this shine off them. Whereas others don't. These are the ones where the chocolate started to harden. I mean, I could have just remelted it, but eh. They still turned out pretty cool. I'm happy with them. So I'm going to put some in a little box for Susan. Once they're all set and ready to go. And give them to her tomorrow. But for now, I'm going to eat this one. And apparently Graham wants a little tiny chocolate bear. And then clean up. We have to clean up. And then I'm going upstairs. Because I haven't been upstairs since about 12 o'clock.
What is upstairs?
What is up there? Actually, technically my room is right there. My window. But yeah. So hopefully you enjoyed the video, guys. I'm going to probably do this again, but with better designing, because I'll get better stuff to design them with. But for now, this is the best I could do, because it's all I had in the house at the last minute, and with money. But I will do this again if you've enjoyed it, and I'll do like better designed ones, and we'll try to do like proper good ones. A bit like the Mickey Mouse gloves there, the way we detailed that a little bit to make it look like a proper Mickey Mouse glove. We're going to do stuff like that. I still don't know what that other design is. It looks like a heartbeat within a heart. I don't fucking know. But anyway. Graham's weird like that.
Yep.
But this is the video. We still have loads of icing left. But anyway. Hope you enjoyed, guys. And we'll see you in the next video real soon. Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. I'm not going to really show you the cookies. Here's a broken one. They're all done. Decorated. Found that really fun to do. Took all day because of people coming in and out and all. And took a lot longer. It took an hour to decorate them. So it did. And that took a very long time to decorate. But they're all done. I'm going to upload a picture soon of them on my Life Goals page. They're all done and dusted. They look tasty. They taste tasty. And yeah. It's another little bit that I did that of stuff that I like to do to make myself feel better when I've been feeling like crap all week.
So I have one more day, which is tomorrow, but I might finish up this video later on tonight and just get it edited together.